Hey everyone, Mike from Just Watch back with a new Just Watch episode. Today we are doing a Flashback Friday review in that we are going to take a look at a watch that was produced about 35 years ago. In this case, it being the Rolex Datejust 1603, manufactured in 1983. This is a 36 millimeter diameter case size watch, which honestly, I didn't think I was going to like on my wrist. I'm so used to, actually, let's do a watch check real quick first here. Of course, I am continuing to wear my Tudor Black Bay Black in 41 millimeter. Still loving this watch and it's still just doing awesome. So anyways, having worn, you know, 40, 41, 43, 45 millimeter dive watches over the last, you know, 20 years, almost exclusively, I didn't think I was going to like this 36 millimeter Rolex on my wrist at all. But I have to tell you, that opinion really changed after wearing it around for a few days, especially here in New England, summertime, it's been warmer. And I've really enjoyed just wearing this little bit smaller, lower profile, a little bit lighter weight watch around on my wrist. And, you know, I'll tell you, the watch keeps fantastic time. This features the Rolex caliber 3035, the 3035 movement. So it keeps really nice time, still running within superlative chronometer specifications, which is a plus two, minus two. And actually this watch does have that superlative chronometer designation on the dial here too. So that is interesting as well. Also, of course, the watch has the classic oyster bracelet, which has been updated over the years, but you can definitely see that lineage. And I think it's really interesting wearing this watch. A couple of things to me that really jump out, at least, is this was always one of my grail watches. It was always one of the watches as a kid that I wanted. Going back to, you know, the 1970s, before, actually maybe the day date was popular then, but I think kind of the staple was the Datejust. You know, you look at Ike wore Datejust, Clint Eastwood wore Datejust, all of these iconic people wore Datejusts all the time, and it was just, it was on so many people's wrists, and it was such a nice watch, and it, you know, the style on this watch has remained incredible even today. You look at this watch and it doesn't look dated one bit. And you think about the lineage on this watch. This watch was originally introduced, the 1945 was when it was originally introduced. It was the 40th anniversary of Rolex. And it was a really cool watch for the time. And it was the first watch with an automatic functioning calendar at the 3 o'clock. And the name Datejust actually comes from the date changed just in time. So Datejust, date changed just in time. That just in time being that it clicks over right at midnight. I think that's kind of a really cool feature with this watch as well. And of course, if you look at this watch compared to, you know, here's today's watch. And if you look at it compared to this one here from 1945, I mean, it's no doubt that that lineage is still there. It's still pretty much the same watch. And you think of, you know, an automobile manufactured in 1945 versus 1945 or a 2018, you know, same model car, there really isn't anything that you would recognize the watch. I mean, I think Rolex just nailed the case design so well right off the bat with this watch that, you know, there's a reason that it's almost unchanged. And it has been refined a little bit here and there. When they came out with a newer movement on this watch, so they introduced the 3035 movement to it, which was the first high beat movement in 1977. And when they did that, they actually slimmed the case down a little bit. They tapered the case down a little bit from the original dimension. So if you look, if you want a Datejust, a vintage Datejust, and you want something with a little bit more meat to the case, look for those older, you know, pre-1977 models, because the case was slightly bigger. Also, they have, you know, introduced two newer models to the line now, and the 36 millimeter has a beefier case. It's a maxi case style where they increased the size of the lugs. And they also did the 126 series of Datejust, which is a 41 millimeter case size. There's actually two different 41 millimeter models available today, although only one available at authorized dealers. That would be the 126 3 series, which is the kind of refined version of the 41. The first 41 millimeter, I don't think they did a great job in the proportions as far as your index markers and the couple of other things. It just, it's not as aesthetically pleasing as the current 41 millimeter Datejust series is. So if you're ever looking for a 41 millimeter online, you'll notice the 116 and the 126 designations. Definitely, at least as far as I'm concerned, I look for the 126 because I like the overall aesthetic of the dial and case more than that first iteration of 41 millimeter Datejust. Anyways, a lot of the design aesthetics that made Rolex, you know, the brand that they are today are inherent in this watch. You have your, of course, you have your oyster case, your waterproof case, you have 100 meter water resistant, you have your twin lock crown, you have your quick set, you have hack, of course, you have your date, you have the Cyclops magnifier over the date, which is one of Rolex's, you know, just key things nowadays. Something that was actually frowned upon back when it was first introduced, but it, you know, it's become just an iconic part of both watchmaking and of their brand. And of course, you know, the engine turn bezel, which still, you know, remains today, although they've gone to, you know, they don't really do the engine turn as much as they're doing the fluted gold bezel or smooth stainless bezel on today's Datejust. But the engine turn bezel to me is very iconic. And I also really enjoy the acrylic crystal that is on this watch. You know, it has that great distortion when you're looking through it. It's actually in some ways, you know, a lot of people really like these acrylic crystals over sapphire because they do have more shatter resistance than sapphire does. Yes, they are a lot softer and scratch up and nick up and ding up more than sapphire, but if you drop it onto the floor, it's not as likely to shatter into a whole bunch of pieces and actually cause internal damage to your watch that's going to need to be repaired by, you know, a certified watchmaker. So anyways, I really enjoy wearing this watch. I've had it on my wrist, my 7-inch wrist now for about a week, and I was really shocked by how much I liked just the look of it on my wrist. And, you know, I thought it was just going to look too small, maybe a little bit feminine, and, you know, wasn't sure about it. But, you know, once I put it on and saw just, you know, the shine that the watch has and just the overall appearance, and, you know, you check yourself like in the mirror, you kind of look at yourself, you know, and see what the watch looks like, you know, coming off of this watch especially. So it's been great. And I haven't had any problems with the 36 at all. I think it looks great on the wrist. And like I said, it's a welcome addition to the collection, something that I definitely enjoy putting on and will enjoy putting on for a long time. That's it for this look back at the Rolex Datejust 36 millimeter. I hope you guys all enjoyed this. And, you know, if you're a bigger person, I'm 6'3" tall and I have a 7-inch wrist and pretty big hands. And, you know, if you're somebody that's kind of afraid to wear, you know, a sub 39 or sub 40 millimeter watch, definitely do think about trying on a 36. Stop over your authorized dealer, or if you have a friend, you know, see if they'll let them wear one around for a day or two. I think you might be surprised too. It does take a little bit of time for your eye to, you know, get adjusted to it, you know, a few minutes. But, you know, after an hour, you look at the watch and it just looks awesome on your wrist and you enjoy wearing it. Everybody, thank you for tuning into this quick episode, this Flashback Friday episode, kind of a different look at watches than our usual review. So I hope you guys enjoy this. Please do hit that subscribe button if this is your first time tuning in. And also please do hit that like button. It just helps us as far as our growth of our channel and everything else. So everyone, I hope you have a great weekend over this weekend, and definitely do let us know what you think in the comments. And thank you again for watching this episode. All right, everybody. Ciao.